I gotta say, now, I mean, obviously there was wheel spin. Oh, you crazy son of a bitch right there, man. Don't burn me back. What is going on, everybody? It's your boy, the Slab Train, and welcome back, guys, to some more Forza Horizon 2. Now, today we have something very special for you guys. The brand new January DLC has dropped on us, the G-Shock Car Pack. Now, this included 5 cars. We're going to be going over 4 of these cars in today's video. Now, today we're going to be covering the 1980 Subaru Brat, the 2013 Shelby F100 SVT Raptor. We're going to also be covering the 2015 Nissan IDX Nismo Edition and the 2010 Mazda Speed 3, and then finally with the 1975 Ford Bronco. So we're going to get this started right away today, driving the Subaru Brat. Now, we are going to be using the whole wheel cam setup for today. GoPro is in session, ladies and gentlemen. Check this out. A lot of you guys were asking me if I was sponsored yesterday for a video, and no, I'm not sponsored by GoPro. I just love their products, stand behind them 110%, and as well, too, they're great for damn wheel cams. Check this out, the testy tandem, man. Oh, did I say test? Oh my god. Chesty tandems, bro. Chesty tandems. I'm done. Alright, so here we are on the road in the 1980 Subaru Brat. Now, this thing is pretty damn crazy. Now, all of the cars that we are going to be driving today are going to be completely stock. The only thing that has been done to these vehicles is slight body modifications, if possible. If not, then we're just driving these stock. So, as I said, with this car pack, it got a little bit of flack for the cars that were given in there, in terms of, you know, using cars that people aren't just gonna really use ever. And I know it sounds like it's got a lot of horsepower on this thing, but this is actually only pushing 69 horsepower. 69. You think that was done on purpose when being made? I don't really know, man. Who knows if that was even a thing back in the day, back in the damn 80s? Who knows, man? But we are driving it today. And the first thing that you'll notice is in the back of this thing, we have 2 modified chairs on here. And I think this is the first time that we've seen Forza put on a modification to the car that didn't come off the factory with. So it's pretty cool to see that they did put these in. This was actually an option that you could purchase on the vehicle, and then be brought over. So it's kind of cool to be seen, you know, on the car right off the showroom floor on this game. And I'm not complaining, man. I love the look of those things. 110% in the back. We have to push this up to third gear, man. We just can't putt up here. We're going to try and see if we can get some air right now, though. I'm down. Now, this thing is weighing just over 2,000 pounds. And all-wheel drive system as well, too, man. I mean, jeez. I don't know. I mean, I'm very excited, and I'll tell you why I'm excited, is because we are able to throw on a V8 swap on this damn car or truck, whatever you want to say. I'm going to say it's a car just because it is made from the El Camino base. So I'm going to say that this is a damn car, man. This is a Subaru Brat, you know what I'm saying? So I know a lot of you guys are asking, Slab, what the hell is underneath the hood of this damn monster? And surprisingly not, this is actually a 1.6 liter flat 4, man. I mean, you can hear this thing pushing just about 90. It's not even gonna hit 90 on this damn hill, and it is just screaming. Now, mind you, I will say that this thing does sound absolutely beautiful. I mean, has there ever been a Subaru engine that you have not liked? I mean, God, I honestly love them all. And this is a perfect example of a beautiful damn Subaru. I love the shape of this thing, and I'm going to be honest with you, before I even seen this in the car pack, I didn't even know that this thing existed. So, you know, I got to hand it to Forza and Turn 10 again for producing some cars in these car packs that, you know, aren't really known by the general public too much. I mean, obviously, you know, the big Subaru enthusiasts will, but, you know, for a regular guy like myself, I didn't really know about this car. So, you know, it's really cool to see. We did have the additional front bar put on the front of this car. That is the only modification that can be done, and you guys can kind of see it at the front there. Not much though, but it is those two additional lights that you guys are looking at right on there. So it's very cool to see this thing, and I'm very excited for doing a drift build on this. As I said, the V8 swap is swappable on this damn thing, so I'm pretty damn hyped. All-wheel drive system will have to go. Listen to this thing just, oh my god. Dropped it into second gear and it's just like, okay, let's drive, man. Get it! Oh man, alright. So I think I fun myself out with the damn Subaru brat. Guy, man, if I go any slower, I'm gonna be going back in damn time, you know what I'm saying? And always remember that motor swaps are changeable, man. We can definitely throw in something bigger and badder. Rear-wheel drive, twin turbochargers, bitch, and we're gonna have a solid damn drift car. But that's another day, man. That's another episode, and we'll be definitely working on that very soon. We're getting some speed coming in here, though. Get it, baby! The Subaru's just loving life. Needle just gets buried, man. Oh my god. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. The 2013 Shelby Ford F-150 SVT Raptor. That is a damn mouthful. And I was right, by the way. It is a Ford in the name. But oddly enough, you actually buy this car from Shelby in the game. So obviously, it's just a modification of the original Ford Raptor that was produced. And really, I mean, this is where the controversy of the car pack begins, because of the fact that this car was already in the game. Now, if you guys are unaware, this is a very, I would say, similar car to the Raptor. The only difference is the four-door conversion to this, as well as obviously the Shelby paint. You have the amazing big damn light system on the front with all the cage and all that, roof rack and all. But in terms of underneath of what you can see, the motor's been beefed up from a 411 horsepower 6.2 liter V8 to a 575, as well to a 2.9 liter supercharger, and a Shelby Borla exhaust system was also put onto this, and it's weighing a massive 6,300 pounds. That is huge, man. All-wheel drive system as well too. A match made in heaven for any damn fan of off-roading, going, you know, sideways with something big. Oh, or even racing SUVs, man. But look at this thing. Oh shit, we got traffic. Let's get back into our lane, man. Oh my god. This thing hauls ass for being almost 7,000 pounds, so I will tell you that. For a fat bitch, it can drive, you know what I'm saying? Oh man. You see how this thing holds on the brake system? Gotta say, those brakes are on point. Wow, man. 7,000 pounds coming to a stop real damn fast. It's not an easy task by any means to do, man. Now, as well, too, the differences from the original stock version, at least in real life, is that it's actually given a set of Fox shocks with wider body parts, as well, too, as a wider wing. Really, that's about it. I mean, there isn't really much of a difference. And I mean, as I said earlier, this is where the actual, I would say, the controversy begins, because this is already in the game. You can go ahead and pick up a two-door Ford Raptor and be done with it. And I mean, to be honest with you, if I could choose, you know, the four or two-door, it's not really a big deal for me, considering, you know, if I could have had something else in the car pack. Now, you know, considering that this is already in the game, you know, there's nothing that we can do. They have already chosen this car to be the fifth car in the pack, and that's really about it. And, you know, for me, personally, I feel like we kind of got a little bit ripped off on this pack. You know, we weren't really given, I would say, a fifth car. We were giving, I would say we were given about a four and a half cars, because this was already in the game. And, you know, if they can do this to the Ford Raptor, you know, why not do that to every car? I'm sure it wasn't too much for this car to be put into the game. Probably just a duplication, you know, extend the doors. I don't really know how that works. You know, if you guys have a better understanding, let me know in the comment section below, please. Because I would love to hear it from, you know, an actual game developer standpoint on, you know, maybe their reasoning for putting this in the game, you know, rather than other vehicles that we've been requesting. That's just my two cents. Other than that, great car. definitely will be making this rear-wheel drive, and I will definitely be owning one of these just to say that I at least own a four-door Raptor with a huge-ass damn cage on here. And now this Raptor does come fitted with other body modifications. As you guys can see, that front lights was not stock. I did put the front light system on there. The back wheel and the top, I'd say, massive roof rack light system can be also removed. It just does pretty much take away everything. Then from there, you can go with an open back, or I believe, what else was there? I think that was really about it in terms of, you know, modification. Just an open back or closed back as well, too. So that's really about it. Not much here from the Raptor. And I mean, like I said, it's just an increase of horsepower, really, that we're noticing, as well as, you know, two extra doors. But I mean, really, there's no damn point. This isn't Grand Theft Auto. We can't take another damn two people with us. Or will it be? This car needs no introduction necessary. The 2015 Nissan IDX Nismo package on this thing. And this was probably one of the biggest cars in the pack for a lot of people. Everybody was like, damn, Slab, you gotta check out this damn G-Shock car pack. I was at my damn placement for school when this thing dropped, so I was wondering what the hell all the hype was about. And I checked it out, and I'm like, oh my god, you know what I'm saying, man? I was pretty damn jacked up myself. Now, if you guys are not aware, this thing just mocks the damn 510. I believe this was announced in the Tokyo Auto Show a little while back, and this is a beautiful damn car. Now, we have been given a lot of damn engine swaps for this car. If I'm not mistaken, the RB swap as well as the SR swap on here. Please, in the comments, let me know if I am wrong on that. I tried looking up the damn motor codes, and you know, Forza is just so damn tough to try to predict what motor is actually going into the damn car. But I'm almost certain it's the SR and the RB. Let me know in the comments below. Don't take your hands off the damn wheel, ladies and gentlemen, or else that happens. Now, the motor that we are using right now is a 1.6 turbo. Oh my god, 215 horsepower. Now, I could not find an engine code on this car at all. So if you guys can let me know in the comments below what the hell this is using, that would be greatly appreciated. Now let's get a little, I would say, a tunnel shot on this thing, considering it sounds beautiful. ...215 horsepower and 210 foot-pounds of torque. Now, as I said, these are all stock vehicles. I have not changed or modified these cars in any sort of way. There will be videos later on regarding drift builds, regarding, you know, circuit tunes, stuff like that. But for today, though, I just really wanted to enjoy the car pack and drive the car stock. Now, you know, I spoke about not really enjoying the cars for, you know, what they are. And a lot of people, you know, lose sense about, you know, what a car is actually supposed to be. You know, they'll probably get in this same car, throw a big bad V8 into it, and be like, oh my god, this is a damn fast car. But in retrospect, though, I mean, this is, you know, it's not the slowest car by any means. Oh! But it's not the damn fastest car either. But obviously, it is a rear-wheel drive base. That's enough for anybody to say thank you very much, Turn 10 Playground Game. So expect a video of this car, you know, if not today, the next day very soon. So I'm gonna give away my videos, but let me just say, though, this car is top priority on my list to build. All right, so take it as you want. I don't know, but this is a damn beautiful car, though. And I mean, everything screams, you know, that 510 in terms of the body shape. You know, the flat kind of squared out look to it. It's so gorgeous, man. I mean, even the color combination is a little bit radical. Obviously, this is, you know, the Nismo package on here. And for, you know, an actual circuit car, this thing is crazy. Now, mind you, I didn't like the other version that they did made. I believe it was just the IDX version. And I didn't really like the way that thing looked. It kind of had that stock beige look to the 510. And I don't know. I mean, I'd like to know your thoughts. I like the Nismo version 110%. Not too sure if I'm a fan of the regular version. Mind you, I respect it. All right? I respect that shit, man. A lot of people said that you step into a damn cockpit or a racing simulator when driving this car. And I mean, look at all the carbon fiber in this thing. Carbon fiber on the dash, carbon fiber on the steering wheel inserts. And I mean, this car is weighing just under 2,800 pounds. And I don't know why the hell I keep going in circles, but it looks good, man. It looks like I'm testing the car out on a track or something, right? Nah, man, this is all freestyle. You know what I'm saying? I'm just kidding. It's all master planned. Or is it? I don't know. But, I gotta say, this thing is hella fun on its own stock. Obviously, this does take a little bit of work to get it sideways, but what the hell was that? Oh, we were pushing that along. I'm like, what the hell? Either way, though, this car is definitely coming in some future videos. Look for it very soon. The 2015 Nissan IDX Nismo package, man. Oh my god. Gorgeous car. One of my favorites out of the pack. So our next car up on the list is the 2010 Mazda Speed 3, guys. And this was a very highly requested car to come back into Forza. A lot of fans wanted this car. And I mean, I can see why. This is an amazing car, man. I love the way that this thing looks. I got a lot of friends with Speed 3s. And I've been in a lot of Speed 3s as well, too. And these things haul some serious damn ass, man. It really does. Now, today we're going to be rocking a 2.3 liter inline 4 pushing 263 horsepower. Now, that's a lot of damn horsepower for a front-wheel drive car, mind you. And also, it's pushing 280 foot-pounds of torque. So, we're going to get a little stop-and-go action right now with this thing, because I'm very curious on how this is going to hold up right now. So, here we go. Redlining at 7,500 RPMs. We're just going to bang it at 7,000 and let it go, baby. Not bad off the launch, I gotta say. Obviously, we did have a lot of wheel spin, and it hooked up fairly quick. I gotta say, now, I mean, obviously, there was wheel spin. Oh, you crazy son of a bitch right there, man. Wow, we were able to save that, though. Got lots of room on that RPM gauge still. Handling is very nice coming through these high-speed sections. We just cannot get this damn engine to shift, though. We're stuck at about 107 miles an hour right now. That uphill is just grinding us right now, man. Look at this thing. Oh, my God. Here we go. Here we go. We're getting some speed right now. I gotta let off. No! We just went right over the damn rail right there. You seen that, right? We died. That's what just happened right there. Oh, my God. Now, this car was given to us with four changeable bumpers, as well as one changeable rear bumper and one changeable side skirt. And then for the hood, you can actually take off that front scoop that you guys can see right there. So it's a nice little package. They gave us a couple front bumpers to choose from. I mean, at least it's something, right? I mean, we can't complain if there's at least something there. And they gave us something there, and I'm not used to sliding a damn front wheel drive, though. See that thing? Right in the damn wall. Easy. I'm gonna try and mod you this, though. Oh my god. Shit! Okay, okay. Here we go. Ooh, baby, just banging right now. Great little fun car to drive. Definitely look for some highway pulls with this thing. Maybe even a drift build if, you know, there's a massive selection of people that want to see this thing. My personal taste on here, I probably won't be taking anything other than a front wheel drive swap on this. I just can't see myself drifting a damn Mazda Speed 3. That's just my personal opinion, though, alright? You can't get mad at that. You can't do that, man. You know what I'm saying? Ladies and gentlemen, though, the 2010 Mazda Speed 3. Nice little fun car to drive. Nice little addition to the pack. Bringing it back from Forza 4 days. I'd like to see it back to you, man. It's nice to be home. You know what I'm saying? Welcome to Forza Horizon 2 Speed 3. The Bronco, the 1975 Ford Bronco, is going to be our final car for today. And I gotta say, I was very hyped when I saw this car, and this was actually gonna be my favorite car out of the pack. Now, my keyword was. Now, when I came home, I rewatched the trailer, and I noticed that they put the 75 Ford Bronco in. Now, if you guys know your Broncos, this is the first generation Ford Bronco. I don't think anybody likes this first generation Ford Bronco. I mean, let's not say they don't like it, because obviously this is a beautiful damn truck. If I seen this on the road, I would take a damn photo of it 100% right away. Now, what I'm talking about is comparing this to the second generation Ford Bronco that is pretty much that everybody knows. And that's where I'm coming from. I was kind of expecting and hoping for that Ford Bronco to be in here, not the damn younger brother to the second gen. And honestly, I really do prefer the second gen body style way more than the first gen body style. I mean, I don't know if that's just me. I really don't know, and it's very hard to see how big this thing is in cockpit view. Look at this damn body roll though. Oh my god. Now, a couple specs about this truck. 205 horsepower and a 5-liter Windsor V8. 205 horsepower. What the hell were they doing, man? Were they on lunch break and just didn't put any more horsepower in? What the hell is that shit? I don't know. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. 300 foot-pounds of torque. Obviously, this thing is a torque monster. This is made for off-roading, I'm assuming. You know, getting into the trails, being able to have the torque and power where needed to really dig yourself out of some serious situations, which is great. I mean, this thing would be a damn trailblazer. 110%. Now, this is an all-wheel drive truck, but we are able to swap in the V8 with about 500 starting horsepower. That is going to be a game changer on this Ford Raptor, and we're going to be definitely doing some serious slides with that thing once we do put it in. So look for another drift build on this Ford Bronco. You know, I was really excited for this car, and then as I said, oh geez, we just made it whine though. You hear that thing? It's like, don't! Oh my god. It's a big bitch right now though, man. Weighing over 3,500 pounds. I gotta say, great little truck. Disappointed though that the fact that it's not the damn second generation Ford Bronco. Let me know your thoughts in the bottom about all the vehicles showcased today. Now, the only car that we did not review today, and that was just because I didn't have really any, I would say, any drive to do that. Now, we're going to have to actually go in and buy the cars. But, I mean, overall, I think we had a solid car pack for January. Things. It's great, girl. Thank you very much for asking. You know, I think we had a great car pack for January. You know, 4 out of 5 isn't bad in my books. And, I mean, obviously, you can count it maybe 3 out of 4. But it's nice to see that we do have a Shelby now. And this was the car that I did not review. Now, this was the Ferrari 500 Mondial. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's Mondial. Mondial, I don't really know. Let me know in the comments below. It's a 53 model. And again, I just had no interest in driving this car. And I mean, if you guys want to try and persuade me to do so, let me know maybe a little bit of history about this. Why is it in the game? Why have they chosen another damn cockpit style looking 53 model in this game? And we have the 57 Testa Roadster. And we also have, I think we had another one as well too. We have something very similar to that already in the game. So I don't know why they keep piling in these damn Ferraris. And I'm sure they have a log of, you know, how long every car has been driven in the game. And I don't know. Let me know. Do you guys like these style cars? Do you guys want to see more road, you know, more street cars, more track cars? I don't know. Let me know in the comment section below. But that's going to be it for our 4 cars of this evening. And honestly, out of the entire pack, I'd have to say the 2015 Nissan IDX is got to be my favorite, followed by the Ford Bronco, and then I would say the Brat, and then I'd say the Shelby, and then the Ferrari in dead last. We didn't get any track time on that thing because I don't even feel like driving it, you know what I'm saying? But ladies and gentlemen, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, and if you did, make sure you guys slap that damn like button down below. Show your support in the comment section below as well, too. If you guys are not already, hit that button down below and subscribe. Become a part of Team Slop today, right now. It's free to do, man. Oh, and start spinning some rubber with me in this Ford Bronco. Ladies and gentlemen, you guys can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, all of which are in the bottom. And if you guys have some free time, come and check me out on my Steam group. Same spot, you already know. Ladies and gentlemen, Jabota Slap Train, I'm out. Peace. Don't burn me down.